where more than half the members of the fire and rescue services are volunteers. This reconstruction is as much about those men as about an extraordinary accident and rescue.
There are 16 of us manning Teignmouth Fire Station. I myself am the station officer there, and I run a small leisure business.
Okay, Chris, well done.
We're going to put this one into the horse and groom. We have mechanics, window cleaners, painters and decorators, a wide variety of trades.
All right, Ray.
Hello, Nick.
How's it going?
Yeah, all right, mate.
We deal with a large selection of incidents, around about 300 calls a year.
All rest, please.
Godfrey Riggs was also working that day. A tree had blown down on his land.
I'd already done some of the tree and just started what I was going to finish, cutting the rest of the trunk up, which I've done hundreds of trees like it.
Let it drop off. Hold it there.
Godfrey was pinned down under the stump, which weighed more than 6 tons. He hadn't noticed it becoming more and more unstable, and it crashed down on him just as he turned for home. He was now trapped and alone.
I was very frightened because I thought I could die here.
It was nearly an hour before his cries were heard.
Right, fire truck, cut it off. Right, I've got to shoot. OK, I'll leave it with you. Do what you can.
The firefighters are spread all over the town, and when their bleepers go, they have to respond to the station immediately. We aim to mobilise one appliance from the station within 3 minutes and two within 5 minutes. Very rural location to get to, involving long country lanes. And we were actually at the scene of the incident within 11 minutes.
There, in the centre.
Right, okay. You just stay there, we'll get to him.
Just thought to myself, where the hell is he? I couldn't actually see a human being until I got within about 4 feet of him.
Godfrey, can you hear us?
In your station.
Okay. All right, Godfrey. All right, mate, we're here now. We'll get you out of there as soon as we can, okay?
The first thing I thought was, I've never, ever seen such a large tree root in my life.
Right, guys, the first priority for us is going to have to be securing this root. It's unstable. As soon as the lines arrive, we'll have to get them attached. Hello, Chris.
Hello, Ian.
What have we got, mate? Right, we've got Godfrey trapped by this root ball. We've not been able to stabilise it yet, so I don't want your guys working around the front.
Just going to give you some oxygen, that'll be great. It'll help you breathe in.
Come on, lads, as quick as you can. Straight past me and up to that tree on the left. OK?
Well done. Be careful, though.
I can't feel a thing. I can't even feel his... No, I can't feel his boots.
While the ambulance team assessed Godfrey's injuries, firemen tried to secure the stump using winch lines.
I'm secure.
Take the strain!
Our lines have a safe working load of around about 2.5 tons. The root was in excess of 6 tons. There was always the concern that they might give when we weren't expecting it.
Hello, sir.
Hello, Ian.
Okay, we've got a man trapped under this root here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because of the seriousness of the incident, a full-time officer joined the rescue.
Well!
Let's get in there with a dig and start digging in there.
They were forced to send men right under the roots to try to free Godfrey's legs and make room for lifting equipment.
Steve! check attention on your line, okay? That's it, good.
They were so worried those lines might break, they did what they could to make the men digging under the stump as safe as possible.
All right, Richard?
Yeah, I'm okay. Stop.
If it starts to move, I want you out, okay?
Grab hold of him, Ray, all right?
In the back of my mind, and I'm sure it was in the back of their minds, if the route was to actually drop, there would have been no time to get them out. And both Godfrey, ambulance crews, and some of my men would have been killed.
Okay, we're ready to lift.
Next, they used high-pressure airbags to try to lift the roots.
Right in green first. Slowly.
Slowly.
Rest, you're getting the shear in action. What I need to be able to do is push and lift at the same time. Stop.
The roots were being moved by the airbags, but they were being moved in the totally wrong direction and would have caused, in my opinion, a lot of injuries to the lower part of his body, possibly spinal injuries, or it may have even killed him.
That's it. Nice press, Godfrey.
Is it blocked?
Godfrey, can you hear me there?
Yes, okay.
Godfrey?
We're not going to be able to get any
steady there.
Steady there, Chris.
Hello?
Chris,
I think we're losing him. He's going on us.
Bob, we've got to go now. Right, it's desperate. Argyle and rescue equipment, Godfrey, quickly.
I could hear everything they were saying, even when I had my eyes shut. You are thinking they're not going to get this off. I'm going to die here like this.
The fire brigade had no choice but to bring in hydraulic jacks called Hurst equipment, powerful but noisy. They'd been reluctant to use it because Godfrey was already so badly distressed.
We were down to our last option, really. And my colleague, Mr. Prince, decided that we would go with a Hurst, and I agreed with him that was about our last hope to do it successfully.
I was concerned, as well as the crew, on severe blood loss, internal injuries, and if we'd been there much longer, then I think we could have had a body on our hands. We wouldn't have got him out in time.
Keep taking the slack up on those lines.
Two more inches. Nice and ready.
Keep it going.
Hold it there.
Stop that.
Hang on, let me check in.
No time, Chris. Get him out now.
Godfrey was finally released after being trapped for more than 3 hours.
Keep us a blanket. All right.
It went through my mind that will this guy ever walk again with the horrific injuries that his legs had sustained, or when he got to hospital, was it going to be necessary for even one leg or possibly two legs to be amputated?
Godfrey spent 3 days in intensive care, and after a month in traction, surgeons put steel pins in his legs so that he could walk again. 18 months later, Godfrey has made a remarkable recovery.
I am really lucky to be alive, I think, never mind recovered. I'm virtually recovered completely. I can do everything I did before, more or less. I can ride. And I just appreciate everything.
At least we got him out in one piece, that's the main thing.
Lucky man.
He wasn't very lucky.